There are still results coming in from all over the country. News from New York, where we are. Andrew Cuomo was elected to his third term as governor of New York. Yes, unfortunately, he cannot make it to the victory party because the subway is stuck. But let's move into more results that are going to keep coming in from around the country. We're going to go into some analysis right now on how it all went down. So please, let's go to Ronny Chieng in our super high-tech election center. Ronny, what are you watching tonight?
What am I watching? I'm watching the other networks suck, Trevor. That's what I'm watching. Every channel is the same thing. Some dude zooming in on his high-tech electoral map, breaking down the vote with deep analysis of congressional districts. In California's 49th, it was expected to go blue. Blah, 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 blah. Boring. That's not deep. I'll go so deep, I'm gonna end up back in Malaysia. County by county analysis? That's pathetic. Neighborhoods block by block? I mean, if that's as deep as you can go, good for you. Try to feel good about yourself. But I'm going all the way in, Trevor, focusing on one guy, Kyle, in Vista, California, on Hillside Drive. Yeah, I'm saying this whole midterm election comes down to Kyle. So, let's go to the hidden cameras I broke in and installed last week. Okay, right off the bat, he's in a bubble bath. So I'm gonna go on a limb here and say he's your typical sensitive snowflake liberal. But let's get some more intel from Kyle's medicine cabinet. Looks like a lot of Gas X and Lotrimine. So obviously, Kyle's a huge loser. But we still don't know how he voted. And I didn't want to do this, but, yo, Kyle, yo! Yo, who'd you vote for, you gassy, fungus-infested loser?
Okay. Ronny, we're good. Ronny Chieng, everybody. Ronny, we're good. No. Thank you. Thank you for that analysis. That was very, very deep and very unethical. Now, there is a lot to unpack from these races, right? But unfortunately, we only have until 11:30 before Comedy Central cuts us off for a rerun of Futurama. So, to get some political analysis and to get it all in, we turn now to our own election experts, Jaboukie Young-White and Dulcé Sloan, everybody! Joining us, guys. Thank you so much for joining us. Like I said, we don't have a lot of time, so I'm gonna have to ask you to both give your election analysis at the same time. So to start, what do you both think about the state of the race tonight?
Thanks, Trevor. Let's talk about the House's chance of flipping.
Arizona, Missouri, Florida, three states that are up for grabs.
And also one for Hillary in
2016. My friend Derek, aka D-Train, has been in all three of those states. Actually, crazy story. D-Train's auntie Trisha claims she once gave a handjob to Guy Fieri in Florida.
Wow. That actually kind of worked. So let me ask you this then. Do you think tonight could be considered as the Democrats' quote-unquote blue wave?
Good question. It's all about those voter 23 turnout. Vulnerable seats.
Generally
Trevor.
Speaking, the more
these
Americans
seats are more
show up
vulnerable
to vote
than a woman after
election,
she watched a double
the results are for
of the
Marty
Notebook and
the
Marley
minority.
And Me. Take my word for it. Do not watch Marley and Me drunk as hell on an airplane.
That is really interesting. I didn't know that turnout was so correlated to minority party success. Now, the last question I have for you is, would you say that Trump's rallies were an asset to the candidates that he supported?
Yes.
No. But it's hard to measure that.
Unleashed shorter than Kevin Hart.
It's like trying to predict the success of a movie like Jumanji.
Look at me. I'm talking about Jumanji on election night.
Thank you so much, guys. Dulcé Sloan, Jaboukie Young-White, I think we can agree we're all more informed than we were 5 minutes ago.